Latest of the art.
Looks like a mouse heart.
That's the total gadget.
And you, when you just put it behind the ear?
No, it's in this.
You have a volume control in there?
I've got a little volume control right now. Matter of fact, I think I turned it up a little bit.
Do you happen to turn it down when we come in for the photo op? No.
Does it have a battery in it?
It's a little tiny.
It eliminates the problem of picking up too much of the auxiliary sound around you.
On a thing like say a state dinner with a band playing and so forth, well, these will pick up loud. But now I am the proud possessor, the first possessor of a pair just a little bigger than this, deeper than these are. And it's got a double circuit. They have been made, this is an experiment of theirs, that shuts out the extraneous noise so that I switch to those for a state dinner or something. But these just are normal wear. My ear problem, I don't know, Jude might be, mine was some years ago on a movie set. Another actor and I were supposed to be running and get behind a tree and turn around and shoot at the bad guys, and he, not knowing much about guns, put that .38 up right here above my shoulder. He was just behind me and blasted away. I staggered about 4 feet and I really found out what concussion is, and naturally we had to do it over again. But years later, I noticed that my hearing in this ear was deteriorating, and more I was turning the other ear. And I went to this fine doctor out there on the coast, and he started asking me. He said, it's the deterioration of the nerves that comes over a long time. And he said, what? And he said, have you ever had any accident or anything? And I couldn't think of anything. And finally I said, well, how far back do you want me to go? And he said, as far back as you can remember. And I remembered this shot thing. And I told him, he said, say no more. That's it.
Who was the other actor?
Bill, they're not very helpful.
I'll text Nettle.
Yeah.
Skirt around that to talk about other possibilities.
If it were to surface, it wouldn't surface until the first of May.
The very time, that's the secretary.
Your top military man, General Galvin, said today that even if you don't give aid to the Contras, they're not going to collapse, sir.
I'll find out when they go.
Mr. Habib, are those designer glasses you have on there?
Yeah. If the Nicaraguans invite him, will he go, Mr. President?
Listen, congratulations.
Are you going to compromise in the end, sir? How about a 60-day delay, sir? How about a 60 or 75-day delay for negotiation?
Reagan, did you put pressure on Merv Griffin and Joan Rivers? Did you or Mrs. Reagan to cancel Patty's interview? Yeah, but a lot of people think it's not a very good book.
You read it?
Yes.
Did you like it?
Negotiate simultaneously with theirs. But we think